united with a friend. He wanted to impress me in the morning with breakfast. So after the meal was prepared and plated and we're about to eat, in walks his grandmother. Right there in front of me, she scolded him for using the dinner wares and not the breakfast wares. Although at the time we were embarrassed, but we enjoyed our dinner and our breakfast anyways. Toastmasters, have you ever cringed when you received a formal invitation, an invitation to a formal dinner? Because you're afraid you do not know which fork to use or when to use it? Toastmasters, don't be afraid. Don't be discouraged. Once the table is correctly set, you can follow. You start from the furthest and work your way inward towards the plate. We know that many of us don't get the opportunity to practice or learn good table manners. Well, not enough for us to be comfortable that we are doing the right thing. So I will attempt to show you, to help you out with that. When you get the invitation to the party of who's who, your table will be set with your dinner plate, usually the largest plate of the set. You would have a salad plate. Most likely would be on top of that. You would have your soup bowl if you are having soup as part of your dinner. That would be placed in the center. Then, we have the cutlery. Toastmasters, this is where most of us fail. We'll start with the spoons. You have your place spoon, which comes on the right side of your plate, the right hand side. You will have your dinner knife. You will place closest to the plate on the right side, the cutting edge facing the plate. If you are going to have steak, you'll need a steak knife. That would come, or fish, you need a fish knife, depending on what it is. You will have your soup spoon. That is usually the curviest or deepest spoon placed outside of your place spoon. And on the left, you will have your dinner fork, usually the biggest as well, closest to the plate on the left-hand side. Your salad spoon, fork, sorry, your salad fork, place after that. If you are going to have dinner, dessert as part of your meal, your dessert spoon, sometimes it comes closest inside, most times it is parallel across from the plate. And you have your tea or coffee spoon as well. Sometimes it's placed to the top. Sometimes it's placed to the top of your plate, and sometimes it's placed outside, sometimes it's on a little plate towards the side of the side. Then you would need to drink water. So you would have your water glass on the right side of your setting. And for those of us who like wine, probably our superhero of the you would also have your wine glass, which will be placed on the right side of your setting. You may sometimes find you have a napkin. The napkin may be placed next to your forks on the left-hand side. Sometimes you put it into a nice design in the center of your plate. And once you sit, Toastmasters and guests, you place your napkin nicely on your lap and you start your dinner. Now, not all settings, not all place settings will have everything we have there. Some of them may have more, some may have less. It depends on what it is that you are eating. Toastmasters, knowing how to eat is also very good when you want to impress your guests. But I will tell you about that in another speech. However, I will not leave without telling you that when you are having your soup, never, ever raise the seatbelt.
Jason!
Make sure you keep it firm on the table and use your soup spoon from the center and away from it and raise the spoon to your mouth. And Toastmasters, do not make that soup. Do not make that soup sound. And Toastmasters, yes, while you are at dinner, shake your elbows off the table. Become a paladin.